No, but we're still really careful about doing it. I think that, and I'm not positive, someone else may be able to correct me, but I think they've lifted the official hiring freeze. But this is, you know, one thing is that you need to make sure you give people their due, you know, and one thing the governor has done, and it's really, I mean, an example is I've got a little cleanup bill that provided for, and I'll be running on the floor, I guess today or tomorrow, but it provides for a district court in Green Forest, which is, it probably, the bill may be unnecessary, but it provides some clarity. Well, the governor's office is calling me, and it's like, well, you're creating a new court, you know, that could be $250,000, what do you got? I mean, literally the purse strings are being pulled tight, and they're looking for every penny, and they're doing it in agencies, and some of his appointments are people who are doing that. It's going to take a long time to overcome 138 years of bad policy, but some of that stuff is actually doing a good job.
Okay, one last question here, and then I want to move to Mary Bentley, and then give you guys an opportunity to soapbox.
Bob, do you know anything about Jake Files, and he's talking about getting rid of all tax exemptions by the next, like, 5 years from now?
Yeah, I actually...
What's that all about?
I actually love that. So, what it does is...
Well, what's he hidden at?
What he's hidden at is the same thing that I hope that other people are hidden at, and that's overall tax reform. So, what he's doing, he's saying, look, we're sunsetting every exemption. If you want your exemption, you need to come back, and you need to explain to us why that exemption should exist, and it should be part of the debate of the overall tax reform. So what is good tax policy? I mean, you go to any of the good conservative living government people, and what they'll say is broad-based, low rates, right? You want it as low as possible, but you want everybody who's possible contributing as can. That's why people push the fair tax. That's why people push the flat tax. It touches everybody at the lowest possible amount as possible. So some of these exemptions is kind of like corporate welfare, right? What it is, it's like, we like you, we'll give you this. We don't like you, we're going to take that from you. And so what you do is you sunset all the exemptions, and then they come back and they say, no, but this one is legitimate. They get somebody to carry that bill, then they come through, it gets put into the task force, and if it is good, it gets carried out. If it's not, then it sunsets and goes away. I think it forces us into a position to have to deal with hard things, and so I don't think it's got any, I don't think it can go anywhere, because, like, you know, all those thousands of people who are getting their own little special treatment are going to stand up and try to kill us, but
what's
I think it's good.
About 5 years? I thought 5 years?
I don't know. I don't know what his reasoning was. The reason why you don't do it now is because there may be some of them that are legitimate, and it would be good to have us to be able to have a debate about whether or not.
Thank you.
Okay,
Louis,
thank you, Bob.
Yeah.
I appreciate it. Mary Bentley. Representative Mary Bentley, I'd like her to share a little bit, if you will, about the bill you're running now. And,
sure.
On